in terms of the financials. That was what the ancients told me. But you know, Jesus spoke to me. So when the elders come and counsel me, I accept their counsel. I say, oh, well done. I've heard you, sir. Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Uh-huh. But I continue doing what Jesus told me. After that encounter, I lost appetite. And the only thing that my tongue could taste, and it was good, was unleavened bread. You will not believe me. Unleavened bread. That was what, if I eat it, it will be tasty. Because that trip was not about my food. And I learned that lesson from the first day. So only unleavened bread became my menu. I came back from that trip. Started hopping from campus to campus. Are you here? Do you realize that the time limit between the obedience and the opening of the second door was 10 years, but Jesus didn't tell me. And you know what? If that calendar opens the next phase and you are not sensitive to know it, it is not Jesus' fault that you did not enter. These guys were asking Jesus a political question. Jesus didn't answer their question. As carnal as it was, Jesus brought another perspective. That in the kingdom, you need to know God's calendar. I did not know. Are you here? I started working for the government in 2004, 1st of June. Are you with me? I went on this trip 2009. Are you here? The period for the Lord to open those gates, he spoke about the nations, was 10 years. Meanwhile, in 2012, I was on cable. I had invitations to preach in 17 countries. So I thought those invitations was what Jesus was telling me about. Oh, you are not with me. Follow me. I thought the invitations that came through cable was that which Jesus spoke about, that when you focus on the youth, I will open gates of nations to you. Then I went back to Jesus to ask him, you open 17 doors for me? And the great one, after tarrying for about 7 days, he said, I didn't open any door for you. Okay, what about the 17? He says, not aware of it. I said, okay. The next year, 12 doors were open. Are you with me? Enter one of them now that Jesus did not sanction. You have the scale of your life. You will not be able to find your life again. Because you went there because of your personal ambition. Every time in kingdom service, your ambition is going to be pitched against the will of God. And if by any means you feel your ambition is something to run with, Jesus will give you the opportunity. Meanwhile, you were created by God to be a kingdom agent, not an ambition agent. It is only a man that has an ambition that will not check the doors that open. If you enter a door without checking with God, it means it was already lined up in your soul to operate like this. And you were willing to take action even though it did not proceed from the mouth of God. Second year, 12 doors open. I went back to Jesus again. 7 days of prayer and fasting. Jesus said, I did not open doors for you. Third year, 9 doors open. I went back to Jesus again. Jesus said, I opened one door for you. And the door was to Malawi. That was the worst of all the doors. The one that I didn't want to go for. That was the first time I knew what it was. It meant to be an apostle. A sent one from God. The kind of power that I had in Malawi, I don't have it even now. Yes. In Malawi, I could know your thoughts in the prophetic. I could know what you are thinking. In Malawi, I challenged the witchcraft of the territory where I went to preach. And 13 of their agents came to kill me on the pulpit in Malawi. It's not this kind of, say amen, somebody. Oh, Maiko Sila Mina Kapola. Agents of darkness, they tore their clothes, they were naked, 13 naked women coming to kill me. People are not possessed in Kaduna. If you see a case of possession here, it's a mild case. What I saw in Malawi is possession. And 13 women were coming to kill me from the pulpit. My interpreter got lost. But the oil was strong. I jumped from the pulpit. I'm talking about a crowd. This is not a crowd. 10 of these is not a crowd. Oh. Those guys don't have any health care. So if a man of God comes, that's when all of them come for healing. Their faith is as potent as soda. Soda soap. It can bleach. Their faith can bleach. Jesus. I ran from the pulpit. And I was running to meet them. As they were running to come and kill the preacher, me too, I was running to meet them. We now met at the middle. I was mad that night. I was, that you could say you want to challenge me. Are you? Of all things, Jesus allowed. He said, but if a human being say wants to challenge you, I'll fight that person. So I have that from Jesus. So when they say they want to challenge me, I say, it don't happen. It don't happen. Yes. The power of God was so strong that those ladies began to vomit living creatures, living things. In one service, you see how many deaf people will begin to hear. It was so intense that the crowd lost decorum and they began to run to hold my garment. It was security agents that took me away from the stage. When I left the stage, the seat I sat on, people now join line. They will sit on it one by one. Now, if that seat were not healing them, they will not be sitting down. The seat was healing them. Oh, we went for water baptism. And when we got there, the Holy Spirit whispered to me, say, Bethsaida. So I entered the water. I said, Lord, let this water heal the sick. It healed from 12 noon to 4 p.m. Water. We were going to the airport. The driver said, my in-law's house is here. So we visited. When we visited him, I greeted him. He did not answer. So he now told me that he's deaf. He's been deaf since he was 9. I said, okay, can you speak to him? He said, yeah. I said, tell him that his ears were here. So when I touched his ears like this, his ears opened. I didn't pray for him before he started hearing. His ears. Oh, I just touched the ear like this. Tell him that his two ears open. He stood up and began to dance. He was 69 years old when he started hearing. He became deaf at 9. He was 60 years deaf. The man began to dance. I saw that while he was dancing, his wife was not dancing. I went to check to ask why. She was crippled. I said, Jesus will make you walk. So I touched the legs. And I raised her up. Her weight was so much, so I kicked the chair. So that she will know that if she doesn't force herself to stand up, there's no chair for comfort. The woman started walking. The guy that brought me started crying. Then their son came from a door like this. And their son said, oh, this false prophet again. I heard it like a human being talking to me. And I went to him and said, you call me false prophet. He denied. I touched him. He was slain. So I left him there. We were only visiting for 2.5 minutes, one cripple was walking, a deaf man could hear, and a lying young man was slain so that he can think on his sins. You know why it was like that? Jesus, he sent me. Meanwhile, when Jesus said he will open the gates of nations, that one was not open. He said gates. That one was gate. The one he said was what? Gates. It took 10 years for that season to come. The fact that God is healing people through your hand, he didn't tell you to start healing service. Because your ambition will always be pitched against the will of God. Meanwhile, there is a calendar. There's a chrono season where you will continue doing what you are doing faithfully and there will be no result. If you become a worshiper of results, you are going to miss God. In this day where you see captions, results, glory, that word is not necessarily a good word. Just or growth is not necessarily a good word, because cancer is a growth, fibroid is a growth. Meanwhile, Satan can give results too. But the thing about a kingdom agent is that he follows instructions that emanate from the mouth of Jesus, his master. Are you with me? It took 10 years. From 2009 to what? To 1990 to 2019. So he now opened, fulfilled his promise. That means after 2019, it's time for me to resign from office. I didn't know that that was the calendar for my being in secular job that Jesus told me that time. It's now I realized. It took 10 years, 2009 to 2019. So that era begins next year. That's why I'm going to leave next year. There is a very meticulous, curious calendar matter in kingdom service. Most of you, you have fire on your life. And because you have fire, you want to do something. If it's not Jesus that sent you, you will die doing it. Many young people will not live long. And the reason is because ambition will push them to go on. The fact that you can speak in tongues, you don't understand the mystery behind territories. You will need to mature. It takes time for God to raise a genuine man. You have not yet known how to conquer lust. You are saying because you can speak in tongues for 4 hours. Do you know lust? It's the ladies in Sabo that you saw that your leg is doing like this. By the time you go to Brazil, nobody is ugly. Aiko saika maikoma neuri musi sabo girls, they like it really like this. You shake. The reason why I don't wear wedding ring is because they say it is the miracle wand that I used to do miracles, that I got it from an ezemo. So I beg my wife. I told her that my covenant is in my heart. I stopped wearing ring. When I went to preach in Brazil, ladies saw that I had no ring. They'll be doing like this. Lord. If Jesus has not helped you, stay in Sabo, don't move on. Mekomaya kosi. The reason why Jesus fragments our function under the kingdom with respect to calendar seasons is so that we can mature adequately before we are released into things. The average believer today doesn't know that God will never use a stone he has not tried. You have not been tempted with money. You don't know what I saw you, Oga. If you see $30,000 in Jim Test bag, I assure you, you don't know what you will do. Even though you speak in tongues. I have seen it for long in the place where I work. Hallelujah. Before I started seeing it, I took a fast for 7 days that God, even the line of duty, I see a bribe. Help me now. Before the, you know, pray before problem comes. Don't pray in problem. That prayer, it can't be right. I took 7 days fasting so that God could purge me of greed. On the fourth day, he assured me that he would be with me since I asked him. I entered into the line of service. I saw money. Money, not in naira. Yes, I saw big money. Sister, I assure you, you don't know what you will do if you see that money. In this day where our understanding of prosperity is materialism, and our fathers that we have followed were the ones that led us astray. If you don't have a personal encounter with Jesus, you are not going to last. If you are a disciple of most of the men in the forefront, you will not go far. It means you have not yet seen him that is risen. Because there are certain things your pastor will tell you that Jesus will tell you something different. When Jesus said to me that I should labor on campus, labor among the youth, people, elders, told me, you have no future. I didn't disrespect them because they have worked with God for long. I can't say no in their prayer. I say, yes, sir. Well done, sir. But I did the one Jesus said. And later, they got feedback that I didn't follow their wisdom. After many years, some of them now say, seems you are making progress there. The same people that say, please help me tell your neighbor, follow Jesus. You have not conquered greed. And you say, I want to take Sabo. You know, this speaking in tongues we do, it deceives many of us. When you finish, go and deal with lust. Don't think of international ministry. I know ministers that were not committing adultery. It was Ghana. They didn't go foul. Oh, you are not with me. Ghana is international. If you cross Africa to South America, that is intercontinental. The farther you go, the more confused you will be if you are not grounded. Hallelujah. You are still thinking of yourself. What will I gain? Don't serve Jesus yet. Go and sit down. When you finish dying to self, then your eye can see accurately. You want to go and do, Jesus is not in it, because it is all about self. Everything that happens is for you. Do you know the level of sacrifice we have gone through? If I tell you, you won't like it. I need to assure you, there's no glory in what we are doing. If it's glory you're looking for, go and walk in Zenith Bank. Hallelujah. We are doing it because we love him. We have been drugged by him. We are drugged. And even though serving him may not make sense to other people, we can't find ourselves doing anything else. There are many people in the office. I was tracking when I was having occasion to receive bribe in dollars that I rejected. I was still tracking. One old man there called me and said, see, you are young and you are rejecting money. What do you know about life? So the system has a counselor such that when you are going astray, they will submit you to the ministry. May the Lord give you understanding. Amen. it is when you have no agenda that God will begin to unveil this calendar to you. And without this calendar, you will walk amiss. Because your life has been fragmented into seasons. It took 10 years for the fulfillment of what Jesus said to come to pass. And if you follow those seasons, you will never be lost. In our first prayer point, when we begin to pray this night, is that God, show me your calendar and show me my seasons therein. Some of you just finished youth service, and then you already have so many ideas. Let me advise you. It takes time to hear the will of God. It takes time in prayer. It is not computer. An escape button. Takes time. You will have to tarry. And he is king. He can decide not to answer you for 2 years. No, this Jehovah sharp mentality that we have, you will miss God that way. It's only a man without an agenda that will survive it. Your calendar will lead you into a trap. Because I know you must have written down, after 2 years, I'll enter into a relationship. And when I finish a relationship, I'm likely to get a car in 5 years' time. And the principalities are wiser than your ancestors. And any time you yield to a desire of the flesh, know that you are falling already. May the Lord show us the calendar. Amen. Second thing that Jesus said is that we cannot accomplish kingdom business without power. And ye shall receive what? Power. After that, the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Without power, you cannot do it. Hallelujah. When you begin to pray consistently, and I'm talking about you are doing like 2 hours a day, and you fast often, you have regimented fasting, that these days in the month I fast, and you don't need an announcement from the altar to do that, and you adopt it as a lifestyle, and you start doing that 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, then the next thing that will happen is that you experience baptisms, series of baptisms, series. You'll be pushed, submerged into many graces. Baptism, it will come like baptism. You will even have feelings on your body. You will live in the realm of baptism for a long time. Then demonstrations will now come into your life. As you are preaching, people before falling, those ones are demonstrations. When you have mastered demonstrations, because initially when demonstrations begin, you will not know that it wants to happen, it will just happen. If you are still on that level, you are not a master yet. It's not yours. You like now I can generate demonstration. I know where to touch God, that demonstration will come out. The next level is that you are in control of the demonstrations. If the demonstrations, the anointing to achieve demonstrations come, you will know in your spirit. And you will know what to do to engage the angels that bring demonstrations. Then, before you enter into power, where people's physical bodies can be healed, it is the realm of power that you need, not demonstration, power, that you need to do kingdom business. Meanwhile, When you enter into the realm of power, then you are going to enter into the next level of the anointing, which is the environmental dimension. Now, in the environmental dimension of the anointing, if somebody carries it, he wears it, it's a big robe. And as he's passing, people around that place will not be able to stand. People like Catherine Kuhlman carry that dimension, environmental. Anywhere they enter, it affects the environment. Huh? That's the second level. With that environmental grace, the people that operate in that grace, their intercession is very, very territorial. It's an indication of a certain kind of rank that God has made available by which territories can be tranquilized. And Jesus is saying, without power, we cannot do apostolic business, kingdom business. And it will take time for your anointing to become power. It will take time. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. If what you are doing cannot affect the environment, because an anointed man should be able to affect the environment. He knows what to do that the environmental dimension will open. And then people begin to fall. And it's not by shout. Are you with me? You can take coffee, can be taking coffee here and activate that environmental dimension. And people will not be able to stand again. There is a measure like that. First of all, the first deposit of the anointing empowers you to do service. You can, if it comes upon you, you can teach. If it comes upon you, you can pray. If it comes upon you, you can win souls. That's the first level. The environmental level is the second level. If you wear that one, the environment will know that somebody has come that has an identity before God. Hallelujah. And just in case you are in a service like this and there is somebody that is an agent. Those of us that were with us in Jaws, they dispatch a few agents to come. You know, I have a history with Satan. Yes, he normally sends people to me, sends messengers. So in Jaws too, two messengers were dispatched. And you could see the hatred in their spirit. So we opened the environmental dimension. And those two agents were humiliated. Because it's that environment, it tranquilizes, sterilizes the environment. That's how we arrested those two ladies. Hallelujah. And when they stayed, we didn't do deliverance. They stayed on that presence for long. I finished preaching first. Then I came and sat on the pulpit and heard their hands, and the demons left. Because I have saturated the environment with my fragrance. That fragrance controls what happens in the place. I've seen demons dispatched through agents to come cause me injury in Nigeria and outside. Same environmental grace. You can't do kingdom business. You come down with paralysis. Because you are going to collide with agents of darkness before it is too long. There's a prayer we'll pray today. You know why? There are witches that live around here. Today, we will disarm them. Those of you that are in Kaduna, you will hear the story. There is something called territorial ministry. And what I'm telling you is not boasting. It is, there are things that I have seen and handled. The gospel that you carry in your mouth is not likely to circulate without power. The time came, apostolic teaching became intellectual deliveries, where people come and talk smart, talk articulate. It was an attempt to rid the church of its capacity. We rejected that model because it didn't look like what Jesus taught in the seminar. And ye shall what? Receive power. There were times when they attempted to put Peter in prison and all of that. But when the disciples gathered and prayed and say, Lord, behold their threatenings, grant that with boldness we might speak thy word, by confirming thy words with signs and wonders in the name of thy holy child Jesus. The Bible says, in confirmation to the prayer, the place where they were staying was shaken. That's environmental. It was after that environmental baptism that the Bible recorded that Peter, his shadow could heal the sick. At that time, nobody attempted to arrest him again. God's answer to political intimidation was grace and anointing for miracles. A man that can give people back their legs, he can take life. So there's a dimension of anointing that is security. That's why of all the things in the hotel did, nobody dared put him before DSS. There is a kind of anointing you can arrest. There is a level. Oh, Yakuma. That's why I say we should pray yesterday. There's something called the gift of walking of miracles. That's the gift with which we can raise the dead. God will do something to you in the next 25 minutes. And when the horn of that kind of grace returns to the church, you will hear our voice. You are compelled to hear our voice. You wake up and say, if the governor of this state travels, he will not return. Anyone close to him, please advise him. There is no road. What I see before him is a bottomless pit. And then the first governor now goes.